Hello, my name is Walt Perko. I am here today to talk to you about the RoboGuts circuit board. This little guy. The RoboGuts circuit board. I designed this board because I needed something small enough to build a billy button. When I started designing the board, I realized I could make a universal intelligent breadboard so that it's easy for everybody to make all kinds of different things with a board small enough to fit into small robots, other small projects, like those little tiny skulls you get. This board can make that skull talk, sing. Anyway, the RoboGuts circuit board went from one idea to build a billy button robot to designing and building a universal microcontroller card, breadboard, smart breadboard, but also evolved to an education program for young children, 5 or 6 years old on up. The idea is, with this little RoboGuts circuit board, you pick the chip you want to use on it, whether you know it's a chip or a module, as long as it fits in a 28-pin DIP package, it'll plug in on here. So the chip of your choice, you start to teach your children the manufacturing process. They take the circuit board, put their chip on, a few jumpers to complete a circuit, and then they 3D print their plastic parts to build their robot or whatever they're going to build with it, or they're cutting up cardboard and stuff, doesn't matter. And they manufacture their own toys. So the RoboGuts starts out empty and blank like this, but as simple as this board is, with just a few jumpers, so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 jumper wires on the board. Oh no, sorry, 10 jumper wires on the board. That's all the wiring needed to add to the microcontroller module on here to turn it into a robot that can talk, sing, and dance, or other animatronic object. The first couple lessons are how to control an LED. This is it, lesson number 2. Lesson 1 is a one-color LED. Just turn it on and off, make it fade up, fade down, things like that. Lesson 2 is a three-color LED. So now you can start going through the whole rainbow of colors, playing with that. Lesson 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, they take you to other sensors. And that, by the time you get to lesson 10, you're adding the little chip on here and some jumpers. So you can add speech and song to your projects. Later on, about lesson 20, I think it's a lesson 20, 19 or 20, right around there, you're learning how to control the motors for little robot projects. Like, at the end of all the couple dozen lessons comes a few project ideas. And one of them, Project X0, is this guy. So by about lesson 19 or 20, you're learning how to control the motors and control the wheels on this guy. You've already learned how to build up your circuit like that one, and you've plugged everything in. You've combined, what you're doing is combining the previous lessons that you learned. You combine the LED, three-color LED lesson with the motor lesson with the speech lesson. Three lessons combined. Turns on and makes this neat little guy.
For contest, 7, for contest. My name is Rich. I am a mini lucky dot. I am a Dipax 28X2G on my RoboGuts circuit or WU is on C, drop and drop. Learn to be a hit.
And this guy, parts all snapped into place. They're all 3D printed on your printer at home. Makes it really easy.
I am a scientist. I am a scientist. I am a RoboGuts. 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 I am a Ro B, not two, not B. We are education. What's the situation when do we take over? It's time to take control. Time to take over. We are the RoboToons. We are the RoboToons. We are the most in the machine.
So as you can see, he can talk, sing, and dance. Simple as that. A little switch, turn them on and off. Little 9-volt radio battery for power. Simple little project. Easy to build, quick to build. You can do it all in one day. You build one of these for your child. Show them how it's done. Let them take off with the lessons. And pretty soon they're making all kinds of toys. The whole idea is that they learn the manufacturing process and they spend less time assembling little plastic blocks like the Legos. They're not screwing metal erector sets together. They just 3D print the parts, and one kit will print. You can print all the parts for one kit in one day. So while the 3D printer's printing the parts out, they're spending their time on the circuit board, learning how to put the jumpers in, learning how to control different sensors and motors and lights and temperature sensors and accelerometers, all kinds of different things. They're learning. They're spending their time with the STEM education, learning the electronics, learning the programming while their 3D parts are printing. By the time they finish all their lessons, they're more than ready to start making their own toys. And the really neat thing is, the lessons are so simple, anybody can do it. Little kids can do it. They don't even need to know how to read or write to do this. All they need to know is copy, paste, and look at a picture. They look at a picture and it shows them where the jumper wires go, and they can plug the jumper's wires in on the board the same way. Then they just click on the picture of the lesson, and there's the programming code. So they just copy, paste it, send it to the chip, program it to the chip, plug the battery in, turn it on, and they can see it work. So it's an incentive for them to actually learn to read and write so that they can start editing the program, making changes, experimenting with the program. That's where parents can help if they want, or better yet, the school should be doing this in the classes where the kids are using the language to learn structured programming language. I hope you enjoyed this little video. I wish I was more entertaining, but I'm just not that kind of a, I'm not an actor, I'm not an entertainer, I'm just the guy that invented, created these little things. So I hope you can buy a RoboGuts circuit board. The RoboGuts boards are ready to go. They're ready at the factory. All I need is a bunch of orders to get a run done, and they'll be shipped out within 60 days of the closing of the campaign. Within 60 days. Because it's basically, that just gives me enough time to have them manufactured, which is about 3 to 4 weeks, and then to package them and put mailing labels on and stamps and send them out. Anyway, I hope you buy a RoboGuts. Thank you. Bye.